Hello everybody, it's Gopinath from the Crackpot Gokulnath YouTube channel. How are you guys? I hope you guys are doing well. So guys, today we're going to see non-uniform circular motion. So guys, what does it mean by non-uniform circular motion? When a particle moves in a circular motion with a varying speed, that means not a constant speed, when the speed varies, and that is what we mean by non-uniform circular motion. Yes, indeed, that's a correct answer. But guys, in today's session, I'm not going to talk about those things and all, but rather, I'll be talking about some of the few concepts which you guys are needed to know under non-uniform circular motion. So guys, first let me draw a circular motion. I'm going to draw a circle, which is circular motion, not to describe the circular motion. This is the circular motion which I'm drawing. Now, this circular motion is a non-uniform circular motion. That means your speed is varying, your speed is not at all constant, your speed is varying as time passes. That is what we mean by non-uniform circular motion. So let me say, this is a particle in it. I'm saying this as a particle and this as the origin. Let me say this as the origin. As you guys know, what is origin, right? Origin means the center of this circular motion. So let me say this as a particle which moves in this circular motion, and I'm saying that this is a non-uniform circular motion. That means the speed of this particle is varying with the time passes. So the speed of this particle varying with the time passes. So that is why this particle is experiencing non-uniform circular motion. So guys, tell me what and all the accelerations will act on this particle. What are all the accelerations act on this particle? Whenever this particle moves in this non-uniform circular motion, what are all the acceleration acts? The first one is your centripetal acceleration, correct na? The first one is your centripetal acceleration which acts towards center. Centripetal acceleration means the acceleration towards center, and that is what acts in this particle, right? For every particle which is circular motion, centripetal acceleration should must act. That and all you guys should must know. So for this particle which is in non-uniform circular motion, your centripetal acceleration acts. So let me represent the centripetal acceleration AC. AC means acceleration on centripetal. So this acceleration towards center is known as centripetal acceleration. Then what is the other acceleration which acts? The other acceleration that acts is your tangential acceleration. Do you guys forget that? Your tangential acceleration also acts. Because this is a non-uniform circular motion. In non-uniform circular motion, your speed is varying. Your speed is varying, dv by dt will be present. In uniform circular motion only, your speed is constant. And that is the reason why your tangential acceleration magnitude, which is dv by dt, is zero. If your speed is constant, your dv by dt will be zero. But here, your speed is varying in your non-uniform circular motion. And that is the reason why your tangential acceleration acts. As simple as that. So tangential acceleration acts because it's a non-uniform circular motion. Your speed will be changing as time passes. So this I will represent as AT. AT means what? I will draw a little straight, guys, because it should be along the tangent, right? So this tangential acceleration is along the tangent of the circular motion, which is nothing but the tangential acceleration acts along the direction of motion. I hope that makes you clear. So I am representing it as AT. AT means acceleration based on tangent, which is tangential acceleration. So centripetal acceleration AC, tangential acceleration AT acts perpendicular to both each other. Correct now? These two vectors are perpendicular to both each other. So that's what I am saying now. Now tell me, what is the magnitude of both the acceleration? What is the magnitude of both the acceleration? The magnitude of AC will be nothing but your centripetal acceleration magnitude is omega square r. Or you can say it as b square by r, correct now? In last session only I told, centripetal acceleration is omega square r, that you learned by your dynamics of circular motion. So centripetal acceleration, acceleration towards center is omega square r. This can also be written as v square by r just by putting omega as v by r, because that's a relationship. Omega is equal to v by r is a relationship between angular velocity, velocity and radius. If we put omega as v by r, you will get v by r whole square into r, which will be v square by r. This way also you can represent. And what is your tangential acceleration magnitude? That is D by dt. So here your V is not velocity, but rather V is for speed, because I'm keep saying that. Don't think that this standard acceleration, which is d by dt, is rate of change of velocity. It is rate of change of speed only. It is not rate of change of velocity. So this V is not at all velocity, but rather it is speed. Okay? I hope that makes you clear. Now, these are all the magnitude which acts on this particle. Now, if I ask what is the centripetal acceleration, you guys would say it is omega square r, or you will say it as V square by r, because both are same by putting omega as d by r. Now, when I ask standard acceleration, you guys would say that's magnitude is d by dt, as simple as that. If you ask those two acceleration, you will say these two magnitudes, just closing your eyes itself, you can say. But now, if I ask you what is the acceleration acts on this particle, what you would say? Now, if I'm asking what are the acceleration, what is the acceleration acts on this particle, what you would say? I'm not specifically asking your centripetal or tangential, but rather I'm just asking normally and basically what is the acceleration which acts. The acceleration which I'm asking is the net acceleration. I'm not asking specifically whether your centripetal or tangential, but rather I'm asking your normal and basically a normal acceleration, which is net acceleration only I'm asking. That means the net acceleration is the vector sum of those two acceleration. Vector sum of both the accelerations will give us a net acceleration of this particle, correct now? So vector sum of both the acceleration will be nothing but, just guys, these two are vectors. So AC vector, AT vector, what will be resultant one? That means the net acceleration will be nothing but, your resultant acceleration will be lying somewhere here, right? I think it will be lying somewhere here. I think that should be the resultant of these acceleration. So AC and AT resultant will be this vector. So this is your acceleration, correct now? If this is your AC, this is your AT, then a resultant acceleration is nothing but your net acceleration using your vector. Guys, I'm using the vector concept only. It's not any new concept and all. Just in 11th standard, you learned the first topic after units and dimensions, you guys learned vectors in kinematics. That is what the basic thing which I am using. So the resultant vector of AC and AT will be A. So this would be your net acceleration, and that is something I am asking now. So what will be the magnitude of this acceleration? The magnitude of this acceleration will be nothing but, listen carefully, this would be root of AC square. 1 minute guys. Root of AC square plus AT square. Correct na? Just the basic thing. This resultant acceleration, net acceleration, will be root of AC square plus AT square, just by your Pythagoras theorem. As simple as that. By seeing this diagram itself, you guys would say that this resultant acceleration, which is net acceleration A, will be root of AC square, which is centripetal acceleration square, plus tangential acceleration square, just by your Pythagoras theorem. That's all. It's a simple thing. So this net acceleration is root of AC square plus AT square. This can be written as A is equal to, which is net acceleration is equal to, I can represent it as AT as omega square r or V square by r. So let me represent as V square by r, okay? Because that's my convenient, right? If you want omega square r, you also can represent omega square r. So AT is nothing but dV by dt. So dV by dt whole square. This is how we represent the net acceleration, because it is root of AC square plus AT square. AC is your V square by r, or otherwise you can represent as omega square r. And what is your tangential acceleration? That is dV by dt, which is your rate of change of speed. Rate of change of speed is only dV by dt, which is tangential acceleration. And that's why I'm writing this dV by dt square, because it is AT square, as simple as it. So this would be your resultant or your net acceleration, which we mean, right? So I'm just finding those things by the what? That's by your vectors. Your basic things, guys. Vector and all you guys learned in your 11th standard. After first topic, which is second topic in kinematics also you learned. In HE or Mandal, you will be learning, I think, in second or third. So, after calculus and all we will be having. So, in those things also you learned, in those chapters also you learned vectors. And that is how I am doing this. And guys, so that's all. So, this would be your net acceleration. And I want to teach you another concept. Okay. So, let me say this angle as theta. If, guys, I'm teaching another concept. If I say this angle as theta, I would say that your tan theta will be nothing but AT divided by AC. Correct na guys? AT, I think I represented wrongly. AT divided by AC will be your tan theta. If you want this angle theta, what you would do? Just find this, which is nothing but tan inverse of AT divided by AC. As simple as that. That's all guys, very simple thing. This one I don't need to even say. Because guys, if this is AC and this is AT, mean tan theta will be nothing but opposite divided by adjacent, which is opposite is AT, adjacent is C, correct na? Because your adjacent is C, so AT divided by AC will be your tan theta. If you want theta, you just put tan inverse of AT divided by AC, just by putting the magnitude of AT, which is dU by dt, which AC, which is V square by R, and that's how you should do it. Very simple thing. Very simple thing. So that's all guys. So if your tan theta is this value, means because of opposite divided by adjacent. So 1 minute, I will take the duster guys. So this is how we will do, just by putting the magnitude of AT and AC. AT magnitude is dU by dt, AC magnitude is V square by R. Just put it the value, then you will get theta as tan inverse of AT divided by AC by putting the magnitude of respective acceleration. So that's all guys, this is your resultant acceleration, this is the value of theta. That is nothing but the angle between the centripetal acceleration and your resultant acceleration, which is net acceleration. So that's all guys. I hope you guys would have understood the concept that I told. So that's all guys. Thank you. Make education simple.